Perfect. Now I will explain the basic premise. This is a really popular false shuffle among magicians and gamblers. Not only is it really popular, but also problematic, because every time I see this shuffle, 70% of the time they flash. Let me explain the basic premise and where do they flash. As I already explained in a previous video, they do the sleep cut. That's the basic premise. There is a way to get away with it without doing the sleep cut, but I will explain those variations later. You know, I do the sleep cut. This is the top half, the bottom half, keeping the top card, which belongs over here on the top half. I'm gonna keep it over here in the bottom half. That's the premise of the sleep cut. And when you shuffle, this is the problem. They unwave, and the single card has to cover the unwaving process, and this top half is going back on top. Okay, and all that is concealed by this single top card. Once again, they shuffle, and then they wave. You know, they do a little bit of a mess on the front to conceal that thickness, you know. And some people, they push the top half, you know, when they wave, they push the top half back to the top just to move it back on its position or original position. And you know, there are so many other ways you see people around executing this move, but anyway, either way they do it, because the top half has to push up against the single card, and more often than not they end up flashing over here in that thickness, at least a little bit of a gap. And sometimes, even though you don't see that much of a gap caused by the top half, you see there is nothing happening on the bottom half anyway. So what I'm doing in this shuffle, as you're watching this performance, I'm concealing the thickness of those two stacks by doing maybe one or two extra steps that I haven't seen anybody doing it. So I'm doing it this way because I believe this is a better way. That's my personal subjective opinion. Everybody has their own. But if I'm teaching it this way, because I believe this way looks much better than Zarrow Shuffle, more than any other variation that I've seen. They shuffle, or I shuffle, just trying to keep a little bit of a V shape, not too much. 90 degrees, no, that's too much. At least 30 degrees. So the audience can see those two stacks are shuffling each other, okay? And before I finish, before I let go this top stack from the top half, before I let go, I push, okay, an angle, a little bit, until it contacts the middle finger of the one is holding the bottom half. Okay, all these fingers are concealing over here the thickness of the bottom half. Okay, so when I push this little stack of 5 to 10 cards from the top half, I push it straight in that way and also outside a little bit in angle. So it conceals the thickness over here, and also it touches the middle finger over here to conceal the thickness of both stacks pretty much. So when I lift, this is the next step. I'm gonna break it down in four different steps, but I'm gonna explain that in a minute. I'm just gonna show you the basic premise. When I lift, I unwave at the same time, okay? So when I unwave, this single card lifts up as well. But it seems like the whole stack is lifting, but it's only the top single card, okay? It's not the whole stack, but the hand is concealing the bottom half. So when I lift, everything is concealed regarding the volume of those two stacks, and then I just push, you know, just keep pushing this way. Just doing a little bit of an acting, you know. When you do the sleep cut, you don't have to do this shuffle twice, but if you don't do the sleep cut, then you have to do it twice to return the original condition. But I will show you that from my own personal view later on. I'm gonna show you once again the steps that I execute in this. Well, I didn't do the sleep cut in this video performance, but I will explain after that what I did. Shuffle, keeping a little bit of a stack, 5 to 10 cards from the top half, pushing, lifting, and unwaving at the same time, okay? And that's it. I already have the top half free from the bottom, but I try not to go this way. Some magicians or gamblers, when they unwave those two stacks, they go this way, and then they move it back on top. I try not to go this way. I still keep in that top half in angle, as you're just watching right now. I'm just keeping this way, because I'm actually have to unwave by going straight like this, but because this card is twist, the top card, it doesn't seem like I'm going back this way this much. And it's not much of an unwaving process. You're not supposed to align those two packets too much. But you have to practice how much you have to unwave, how much is too much or how little is too little. So you have to push it up and you have to do that little acting as if there is a lot of friction, you know, among the cards. Okay, so point number one is doing the slip card. Point number two, waving, making sure you don't leave a huge angle, just a little bit. So that you can see it is mixing. Point number three, before you let go, you're supposed to push those cutting angle until it contacts the middle finger or the bottom half, the hand that is holding the bottom half. Point number four, unwaving and lifting the top half at the same time. And because this card is right on top of the bottom one, it seems as if the bottom half is lifting as well, but it's not. So the next point is just doing a little bit of an acting, you know, putting those two packets again together. But you are concealing, that's the basic premise. By lifting a little bit, it doesn't look too suspicious, but you're also concealing over here the thickness of both stacks. Let me explain from this angle, how do I get away doing this shuffle without doing any slip cut? So what I do, I'm taking the top half. I'm gonna leave this card face up so you can follow it better. And this card from the bottom half as well, face up. So you can follow those two stacks together. I'm doing the shuffle and it's still doing the move as I already explained. I'm gonna give you a quick recap all the way at the end, just in case you're still not getting it. So I'm shuffling, lifting, and then I have to keep that top half over here with my thumb break. Obviously you don't see that huge thumb break from the front. Over here in the front is concealed just from the back. So now I'm gonna separate those two packets again. But notice I'm taking the bottom half with my left hand. The first time it was the top half, now I'm taking the bottom half and do exactly the same. Okay. Push. You have to push and the move. Okay. And then for a second time, you have to keep the thumb break, separating those two packets. And at this point, you can just do one hand cut or do two cuts just to bring the bottom half back to the top. Okay. And that's it. The whole deck should be in the exact same sequence. Okay. Now I'm going to give you a quick recap, breaking this move in five different steps. Still, I'm going to leave this card face up so you can follow it better. Point number one, slip cut. Okay. Or just the regular cut. But if you don't do the slip cut, obviously you have to do this shuffle twice to return the sequence into the original condition, okay? Point number two, shuffle. Notice the shuffle is not a 90 degree, that's too much. It has to be at least 20, 30 degree. That's good enough, so at least the audience can see you're shuffling both stacks. But before, point number three, before you let go, you have to push, okay? This little chunk from the top half in angle until it contacts the middle finger of the other hand, the hand that is holding the bottom half. Push that way and that way, so it conceals the volume of those two stacks. Now the next step, when you lift up, you unwave the cards. You don't unwave and then lift, you unwave and lift at the same time, okay? So when you lift this packet, the top half, you're gonna lift the single card as well, concealing or insinuating as if this bottom half is also lifting up because this single card is lift. So just do the little acting as if you're putting those two stacks together because of the friction, okay? So once again, cut on the slip cut, shuffle, okay, push, that's the third step. Four, lifting and unwaving. And fifth, doing a little bit of an acting. So that's it, pretty much by lifting. As you can see, by lifting the top packet, the top half, it's gonna conceal this move much better, and I believe it's gonna make it more convincing and easier as well. But you know, this is a pretty subjective opinion, and that's why I'm presenting this shuffle to you. So if you still have any questions, just make sure you post it in the comment section down below. And I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial.